But in church, we deal with people or in organizations, even such as this, you deal with people from all walks of life. You deal with cashiers, bankers, tellers, whoever, accountants, like you said, masters, whatever. And so you deal with one of the most important things that my lady told me as a young, timid person, looking in the faces of almost 30, 40 people, and I see all of these people who well off in life. He said, listen, as a leader, you always go to your people with a finished plan, right? So you don't go there just on an open sheet. You don't have no ideas, you don't have no interjection. You have to go there. When you stand in the middle of your group or your team, you have to already have a plan. And you have to give that plan to them. And then you can leave room for them to add or even comment on it. But you have to, because that team would rise and fall on you. If that team fail, it goes on you. And so you have to always go to them. You have to, as a leader, in all circumstances, you always have to have a plan. You always, that's why the leader's life is different. The leader just can't go home and watch TV all day, all night. He can't just go to the movies, shop, and do all of these things. The leader has to have time to study. He has to have time to pay attention to what's going on. The leader has to always be aggressive and in the know concerning his team or where he at. And so when things rise, he always have a plan. He always have something to say because that's how his life is. And so once you study so much and once you love and passionate over what you do, the Bible says it like this way, you have to always be ready to answer to what you believe in. And that's what leaders need to do. And so you wouldn't have the problem because imagine an uneducated leader who didn't finish school, standing over doctors and lawyers, and they stand as leaders. So they're looking for you to be lost of words, they're looking for you to not know what you're doing, just to have an excuse to say that you're not qualified to be. That's all it boils down to, you know. The people right around you, they have a mindset to say, man, you're unqualified to lead because I'm better than you at this thing. I know more than you. But all of that don't matter. But if you don't have nothing to say, why you play right into that trap? And that's when dissension comes in. So you have to always be ready to lead.
I have one.